Hello everyone, and welcome to the next part in Let's Play Hattrick with me, Alfapiomega. Today I got a massive amount of news for you guys, so I don't even know where to start, and I'm hoping I'm not gonna forget anything. So let's get on with it before it's too late. Why would it be too late? Well, that's because I'm selling three of my players. I'm selling Daniel Sindel, I'm selling Zdzisław Mosler, and I'm selling Aleš Němec. All these three players are selling currently for way more than I was expecting. Let's check them each so that you know what I'm talking about. Daniel Sindel is currently selling for around 77.3 million Czech crowns, while in Transfer Compare, his median value is set to 56.2 million and average to 61 million. So that is about, if I'm not mistaken, 16 million above the average. So that made me extremely happy, to be honest. That's way more than I was expecting, and I don't even know what I'm gonna do with all this money. Zdzisław Mosler has even better numbers. He's selling for 15.5 million and he was supposed to sell for a median of 11.4 and the average of around 14 million. So he is 1.8 million above of what I was expecting. So it was Aleš Němec who was supposed to sell for way less, not Zdzisław Mosler. Because. Anyway, Aleš Němec is the guy who was supposed to sell for less. His median is 9 million and average 10.4, and he is selling for 15 million at this point. So altogether, for these three guys, I'm gonna get 100.8 million, that's how you would say it in English. So I don't know what to do with that kind of money. I have 23.2 million after this week, and so I'm basically swimming in cash right now. The fact is that I ran the numbers, and as far as it goes, we're selling the least, well, we're selling the players that have the least ahead of them, you know. I understand that Daniel Sindel has the highest playmaking, and so does Zdzisław Mosler. But right after Zdzisław Mosler, we have Iriome Cabrera, who has higher defending and even higher winger. So he is already better than Zdzisław Mosler, and he is 5 years younger. He also has better set pieces, though the passing is way weaker on Iriome. But you know, this is just gonna go up much quicker than on Zdzisław Mosler. So Julian Wolbebauer still better. Well, actually, no, he's about the same. Brilliant playmaking, same defending, and slightly weaker winger skill, but also much younger. He's 18 years old and 100 days at this point. Right Tilker, again, brilliant, excellent defending, and inadequate winger, and is 19 years old. So both. Well, actually, all three of these are gonna be way, way better at the age of Zdzisław Mosler. Who's next? Aleš Němec, who has outstanding playmaking and, you know, arguably, he's an excellent winger. He has very high rating, but, you know, he's 26. He's not gonna get anywhere better. And both Aleš Němec and Zdzisław Mosler are my... What is it called? He's like, this is their home mother club. Okay. Teje Vysočany is their mother club, so they have been with me since the very beginning. And that means that whenever someone is gonna sell them, I'm gonna get a ton of cash for basically nothing. So that's awesome. Then we have David Burgess, Hieronym Kobielusz, Kazimir Eisleben. Oh, by the way, that was funny. He got a massive boost to playmaking in the past weeks just being with me. But slowly, this guy is gonna have to go out because his skills are getting weaker and weaker. Then Gometaswar and Václav Balón. I'm gonna have time to train everyone now after I sell these, well, those three players. Ettore Guido is a defender. I'm gonna start training Jernej Vukan and Mika Turi as well, but I'm planning to sell them at the end of the season, so they're gonna get a bit of a boost to playmaking, and then I'm gonna sell them. I don't know how much they will sell for, but I know that. Oh, someone actually increased. God damn it, that was loud. I have to lower the volume. I have my headphones next to me and it just screamed. So wait, this is Jernej Vukan. Where is Mika? Mika Turi. So Mika Turi should be, yeah, 10, between 10 and 11 million. And that was for Jernej, and Mika Turi for about, yeah, around 9 million. So both of these will be sold at the end of the season. And after this season is over, I'm gonna invest a bit in my team. I should. And that is something that have been bugging me for quite some time. I have very bad keepers. Like, seriously bad keepers. I should get better ones. But the problem is that, you know, getting a better keeper is just so expensive. So expensive. Anyway, how much could they raise it for? Zisov Mosler, Zisov Mosler, Zisov Mosler. Oh, he's at 17 million now. So total earnings 102.9 million. And Daniel Sinder is going to be sold at any second now. He maybe even was already? No. For Zisov Mosler, who did you raise for now? Yeah, that was Aleš Němejc. Okay. So Aleš Němejc as well. Damn. This guy's gonna earn me a bit more. 103.2 million. I wanted you guys to see the last minutes. Daniel Sinder has been definitely sold to Sagiata Seaku. I'm not sure how to pronounce this. It's a Romanian club. So he's basically going back to his home club, or home country. Which is kind of understandable because they don't have to pay him the 20% bonus. And he's back in his Romanian club. What kind of club is it anyway? Not a bad one, it seems. Sagatam. 5/5 out of 7. Well, they're spending their money. I hope Daniel will serve you well. He still has a very high potential. I don't know what they're training, but if they're going to train him as a defender or a winger, he's going to become incredible. Really. And you know, if you think about the fact that I bought him for about 8 million, I got 812% profit on him. 22.9 million per season I owned him. That is incredible. It was a good investment. Daniel was a good investment. I am quite happy that I didn't sell him when my mentor told me to. But, you know, he said it, that Daniel Sinder is the only guy who he would consider hanging to, but that he would sell him. So I didn't, and I sold him now, and, you know, I'm really happy about the price. So who did you race for now? Oh, Zisov Mosler. 18 million. Wow. I had no idea he would climb so high. He's about 18 million. So he's about 4 million above the average. And almost 7 million above the median. So who's hanging to him now? Okay, they raised a bit more. And Aleš Němejc is now sold to FC Jaroslavl. It's a French team. In the 6th division. And they're fairly good. How many? 1600 members. So I hope Zdisov will serve you well, because he's a good player. Well, actually, no, that was Aleš. Aleš Němejc. A good guy as well. And Zdisov Mosler, 20 million! Oh my god! He went up too. He's only 24, you know, and he's not bad. I mean, come on, get me more! how am I gonna do now with the finances that went up 109,664,000? I never had this kind of cash at hand. So, and he's still not sold, you know. Oh my god, they raised again 20.4. I'm actually looking at this player. I'm thinking about buying him when he is sold yesterday. I still got an entire day on that. But his playmaking is really weak, but he's really young and has a great defending and winger skill. So he could become extremely good. He's also quick. So this guy would be great. 25 million, that's a complete bargain. I think that these guys... Actually, no. I'm surprised. I thought that players like this would sell for way more. That's interesting. What is dragging him down? 25 million. Because I was searching for a high defending and winger skill, and he seemed extremely cheap. So let's have a look. We're gonna go with a 17-year-old guy. Defending and a winger, at least excellent. I'm gonna search. Yeah, you can see that the money are way higher. Yeah, he's basically here. He has a TSI of 3,830. And most of... Yeah, this guy... Oh, that's an opening price. No one bought him. Excellent, excellent, poor. So this guy is even worse. And he's asking for 30 million for him. This guy has 60 million. Oh yeah, but he has a formidable defending. Did they increase the price again? Weak playmaking. So this guy would be good. But... Yeah, I think this could be a good investment. The game is telling me that 25 million isn't so good. What about Alfonso Rodriguez? Okay, Alfonso's playmaking is way worse. And this guy doesn't even have a specialty. No, I think I'm gonna go for him. I don't know how high I would go. So maybe you guys could tell me how much you would buy this guy for, but it seems like a good investment. Passing is not that bad, and if we got playmaking to about excellent or maybe even higher, we could sell him for a big profit. TSI based prediction. He has a really high potential. Central defender. He sucks at this point, but he could be better. Oh my god, are they still trying to buy him? Oh my god. 23,990,000. Come on, guys. You can do better. Get it higher. You can still get him higher. FC Alcohol. It's a Netherlands team. Well, this seems to be the last increase, 23.9 million. I don't think it's gonna go higher. Damn, he sold for so much. Almost double of the average value and over double of the median value. Come on, is it gonna change? I could use this as an omen to buy Innocent Puder. Was he sold previously? No. No, wait, he was. In December. His TSI was 1,870. A spike team. I really think this is a good investment. I really believe that. What is the potential on some of my players? Let's say The youngest ones. So Karol Bartowiak has a potential 2058. He is formidable and solid. And this guy is excellent. And he's way older. So Bartowiak is just an incredible buy. How much did I get him for? Like 12 million, didn't I? Transfer transfer history. Yeah, 17 million. So I actually bought him for... This is just so ridiculous. I bought him for half of what the guy paid for him. That's not good business. Why did he sell him? I will never understand. But yeah, I really think this guy could be good. I really think so. So anyway, I'm gonna... You know, on the other hand, I really don't have any reason why to rush things. So Zdzisław was sold for nearly 24 million. And that means that we currently sit on... Well, it hasn't been counted yet, but... It's gonna be some 140 million, maybe even... I don't know how much. No, this is both of the previous players, so it would be 130 million. So that should make my sponsors fucking insanely happy. And I'm gonna sit on this cash for some time now, like a frog on... wow, what's it called? Frog on a... There was a story about frogs sitting on a spring, you know, and trying to eat it all up, or drink it all up in this case. So anyway, this was my transfer. I'm glad you guys saw it, because that was just freaking insane. Yes, 132.4 million at this point. And next week we are playing on our turf. But this was just only one thing that I wanted to speak about. Let's move through those that we don't really need to spend much time on. Dancing in the Streets, my fans are growing again, because we have won a tournament match. Which one was that? I think it was this one. It would be a close affair, and we won it 1-0. So they became extremely happy, and we are gaining fans pretty quickly. So that makes me feel good. Finances we already spoke about, transfers as well. But now let's look at the series. I actually am kind of surprised how this changed. The teams that I was playing with are gone. They just left. All of them, except me. And we have four bot teams and three new teams, of which I can only fear one of them. So it's FC Bombardier, which is a completely new team. I don't really have anything to fear from them. Then we have FC Rapid Kročehlavy, or it's SK. So SK Rapid Kročehlavy, which is also a new team completely, 132 members. And then we have Muglinov, which actually is a good team. They have a high amount of fans. So my... They're selling Pascal Carrieux right now. Asking price. Yeah, this sucks. This guy sucks, and he's 32 years old. So we'll see what Muglinov is like. I don't know if we can see club history. Negotiated Hattrick. Okay, so they moved from their own division to ours. And they were third last season. How old are they? The team was directly demoted. Muglinov finished as number 7. The team was directly demoted. What the hell happened to them? They were being demoted every season. So are they like falling apart or something? They got all the way to number 3 division. So it's a bit weird. Forum sneak peek. Oh, there was some talk about change. Yeah, Mopa Cities is saying that they tried, that they decided to go somewhere else. And that they are saying that It is sad that nobody was promoted, and they're thanking for everything. Oh, and they're saying hi to YouTube. And Narcos Nietzsche also left. Where are they now? They're in a different division. Oh, they left with Mopacity. Ah, I see. And with Odricity as well. Oh my god, all of them left to a different. I'm the only one who didn't, and I was the one speaking about it. God damn it. So anyway, what I was trying to tell you guys is that we have an entirely new situation here. We have to think about our strategy carefully here. We're gonna play with one of the new teams next season. When are we gonna face Muglinov? That's the question. That is the question. So fixtures, Muglinov. Okay, not here, not here. Okay, so in about 4 weeks, in a month, we're gonna play against Muglinov. So a lot can change till then. I'll have to try to, well, actually, can we see how they played already? Easy pod Valmas, 4-0. Or why not? So this is Muglinov, and they're not all that good, to be honest. They're probably training completely new players. So that means we could actually win this one easily. But you know, that might have been a bot team, because I prioritized the play with Barca or Slovan last week as well. By the way, we're not gonna stay in the cup. FC Slavia Brno is a team in the third division, and they're just gonna murder me. I don't even know him. If there was not a single player in there from me, I would still, you know, have the same result as I'm gonna have with them. So that's a bit sad, but a completely new situation. Completely new situation. I'm gonna enjoy this quite a lot. Sad that we are gonna leave the cup so early. But I think that... Oh, they're gonna play with me on my... At least we're gonna get some money out of that. So, because we got some money out of this match as well, around 6 million? Yeah, 6,188,000. So, that's gonna be fine. And that next match is gonna be played at my stadium as well. Because this one wasn't. So, we're gonna get another around 10 million next week. Just for nothing. So, this is gonna be a cash cow, basically. Just gonna be raking in so much cash. I should really think about what I'm gonna do. I think I should buy a new keeper, some new long-term defenders and stuff like that. But you know, that could take so much out of my team easily. Well, anyway, the youth team is the last thing I'm gonna speak about now, because this has been going for quite some time. You're barely used to having long videos in the Hattrick series, I'm sure. But there has been a lot of things happening. So we got a new player. I think it was Daniel Matsura is the new guy. Again, our team is going vastly, vastly in the 15 to 16 years old area. Igor Hervert is just going to be fired now because he's completely useless. Actually, you know what? We got the money. So let's promote him. I doubt he's gonna be worth anything. Actually, defending inadequate, passing passable. Does he have a... He has a nice potential. Let's put in Hout with a zero. I would like to give him a chance. Maybe someone will buy him for 40,000 and train him. He's not all that bad. You know, if someone... Actually, if no one buys him, we could even train him. Defending, he's way below what I need, but looking at it right now, he's not all that bad. You know, for me, actually, this is with the loyalty and the mother club bonus, so it's a question. But yeah, again, the youth team is going places, and we have some players that might be good sometime in the future, like Boris Tatur, so far seems like a good candidate. If I promote him when he's rivet 17, just flat, and he will have inadequate passable, I might even consider having him in my team as a trainee for a couple of seasons and then sell him with a profit. That would be the first guy. No, he doesn't have any specialty, and that sucks. Other than that, I'm just, you know, winging it, sending them there and back. What was that? Oh, Ingor Hanovan has been transfer listed. So yeah, that's pretty much it. As far as training goes, we had only one change, and that was what? Oh yeah, Kazimir Islaban improved his playmaking, and Karol Bartowiak, oh yeah, our player number one increases playmaking, so he's going places, man. This guy is going places. And the last week, I don't think anything important changed. Yeah, Kazimir Islaban, his playmaking dropped, and now he's back up again. Jernej Vukan increases playmaking, and Raik Dilher, his playmaking improved. I'm actually thinking about buying some really good wingers for my B team. And just training them on the wings as guys who will train playmaking, but it's all I really don't know. If you guys have any advice for me, I'd be happy to hear it, because I am somewhere locked in the middle rebuilding my team, trying to improve it. But I would appreciate any help. So that's all from me for today. There was a lot of it. You know, I know I've been speaking quite some time now, but I hope you enjoyed it. There's so much that we can look forward to, and I'm happy about that, because again, this is getting more and more thrilling for me. So let's hear it for this season, which may be the season where we actually get promoted. So see you folks next week with some more Hattrick.